Hello everyone, today we learn about amplitude modulation. Without wasting any time, let's begin.
Amplitude modulation is the process of varying a transmitted carrier in order to convey information. There are three things we can change about sine wave: its frequency, phase and its amplitude. And amplitude modulation or AM, we convey information by changing the amplitude of carrier. AM is used variety of application. Most people of course very familiar with the use of AM, radio broadcasting, and many applications areas, EMC testing, etc. How do we create AM signal? Most often AM signal are created using a mixture the inputs to which are unmodulated RF carrier and low frequency modulating signal. The result is modulated RF carriers whose time domain envelope is a copy of the modulating signal in the frequency domain. The information in an AM signal is contained in so called sideband and appear both the below the carrier frequency. If we use simple 1000 hertz sine wave signal or modulations, the modulating signal appears to two tone spectrum, 1000 hertz above and 1000 hertz below the carrier of a total signal. Width of this modulating frequency, human speech on other hand contains very broad and non-uniform spectra content. So if you human modulation source will also be broad and non-uniform, total width of AM modulate signal will be twice the width of highest modulating frequency. As we have just seen, an AM signal consists of two parts, the unmodulated carrier and two modulated sideband. The AM modulation index usually with lowercase m describe the ratio of carrier and sideband amplitude. In other words, m is sideband amplitude divided by the carrier amplitude. We can measure the AM modulation index using two different types of instrument, can be oscilloscope measure modulation index, spectrum analyzer to measure modulation index. The frequency domain presentation note that may also hear the expression AM modulation depth, that is modulation index expressed as a percentage, and AM modulation index 0.85 is the same thing as an AM modulation depth of 85%. We'll start our explanation of AM modulation depth by looking AM signal in the time domain. The amplitude of carrier wave, blue line in changing over time, red line indicates what usually called the envelope of the signal. The envelope has maximum and minimum value. We'll designate the midpoint between this maximum and minimum value sub C, and well distance between midpoint and peaks and sub M the modulation index M. Simply sub M divided by sub C in the time domain. It's very easy to see. We sometimes refer to this AM modulation depth in case M equal 0.1 or 10% modulation depth. We can see that the envelope doesn't stay carrier, the modulation index or modulation depth increase the distance between the maximum and minimum annual of values. The peak and trough also increase when we get M equal to 0.9 or 90% modulation depth. Dip valleys or trough compares to the show valleys when modulation depth was only 10%. In case you are wondering, possible to have modulation index greater than 1, this is called as over modulation. In over modulated signal, the carrier exhibit 180 degree phase reversals where the envelope crosses the zero point. Over modulation is undesirable because this phase reversals give right to sideband. Serious interference sometimes refer to a splatter nearby spectrum. As we saw a few moments ago, an AM modulated signal in the frequency domain consists of unmodulated carrier, two modulated sidebands, one upper sideband and lower sideband. The values of sub C and sub M from our time domain discussion are also shown as here. Modulation depth M can be calculated in the frequency domain by measuring the difference in amplitude between carrier and sideband. This difference N is normally negative and expressed in dBc. We can then calculate the modulation index using a simple formula as we increase this modulation index M, the amplitude of the sideband increases and sideband increases, and N the difference between the carrier and the sideband therefore decreases and it's important to note the carrier amplitude in unaffected by modulation depth, not also that frequency spacing or distance between the carrier, and sideband does not depend on modulation depth. In the time domain, we can calculate the modulation index m using an oscilloscope and called as trapezoid method. It is done by placing scope xy mode, with x being low frequency modulating signal and y being am modulated or tetra rf signal. Trapezoid to appear on the scope, and modulation index is calculating length of two vertical edges A and B, as well as simple formula. Scope generally don't have automatic measurement. Functionally, for a modulation, depth, edge, length must be determined using manually placed mark. This can be decreased measurement accuracy and reliability. The shape of the trapezoid change, we change modulation index. Modulation index increase the left edge, the trapezoid being shrink increases the ratio between these two edges. Note, however, that width of the trapezoid is unaffected by modulation depth. And so, in summary, amplitude modulation is used in wide variety of applications, such as broadcasting. EMC AM signals are generated by mixing an unmodulated RF carrier. A low frequency modulated signal, if you look AM signal, the frequency domain with modulation appearing as spectral sideband, with total width of the modulating signal being equal to twice the highest modulating frequency. Most common measurement of the signal modulation depth, modulation index, can be done using either spectrum analyzer or an oscilloscope.